What do you think would hold it off, Mr. Moss?
Nothing. I mean, you'd have to have a war. You're kidding.
You're not kidding.
During Reagan's administration, 240 Marines killed in Beirut. 24 hours later, we invade Grenada. That was their M.O. Change the story, change the lead. It's not a new concept. Like the only touch that we'll talk more about.
Wait a minute. We can't afford a war.
We're not going to have a war. We're going to have the appearance of a war.
We cannot afford the appearance of a war.
What'll it cost?
But they would find out.
Who's going to find out?
The
American people.
Exactly.
Who's going to tell them? What'd they find out about the Gulf War? One video of one bomb falls down a chimney, blows up the building. The building could have been made out of Legos.
You really want us to go to war?
That's a general idea.
With who?
I'm working on it.
The president's going to go to war with Albania in about 30 minutes.
He's declaring war in Albania?
No, we're not declaring war. We're going to war. We haven't declared war since the Second World War.
We're going to war.
Question. Why do people go to war? Why do they go to war?
I'll play your silly game.
Okay, why do they go to war?
To ensure their way of life.
Would you go to war to do that?
I have.
And if you went to war again, who would it be against? Huh? Your ability to fight a two-ocean war against who? Who? Sweden and Togo? That time has passed. It's over. The war of the future is nuclear terrorism. It is, and it'll be against a small group of dissidents who, unbeknownst perhaps to their own government.
U.S. military officials confirm Al-Adnani, with a $5 million American bounty on him, was targeted in an airstrike near Aleppo yesterday. But U.S. officials are not confirming that he was killed. ISIS could certainly replace Al-Adnani, but losing such a key figure, the organization's public voice, would be a setback. Savannah?
To go to that war, you have to be prepared. You gotta be alert. The public has gotta be alert, because that is the war of the future. And if you're not gearing up to fight that war, then eventually the axe will fall and you're going to be out in the street. And you could call this a drill, you could call this job security, you could call it anything you like. But I got one for you. You said go to war to preserve your way of life. Well, Chuck, this is your way of life. And if your spy satellites don't see nothing, if there ain't no war, then you can go home and prematurely take up golf, my friend. Because there ain't no war but ours.
Okay, good. Put the village behind her.
Give me some flames. How about some screaming?
Screaming's good.
Some sound of screaming. Oh, you know, it might be good as ooh-ah sirens.
What the hell is ooh-ah?
Yeah, ooh-ah, ooh-ah, Anne Frank.
Oh, okay, that's good, yeah. Oh.
Find us the Anne Frank sirens.
Oh, that's chilling. Give me goosebumps.
Find us the ooh-ahs.
Hello? Yeah, we're going to be back in Washington, when?
We'll be back tonight.
Tonight is... It seems that Senator Neal has discovered something.
Well, it makes no difference about Senator Neal. I don't care what Senator Neal's got. We got a war.
Been here once before. Been here once before.
Time key means you can use any background that you like. This is what the background looks like. This is the true background that we filmed this on. The chroma key means you can have any background that you like this, or maybe this, or maybe this. We'll be right back.
decide when this goes national, I get to put it on my resume?
Actually, no.
Because, like, what is it, a guild thing or something? I mean...
You can never tell anyone you did this.
What could they do to me?
They'd come home to your house and kill you.
Tested. Deploy the P3 before it's fully tested. Yeah. Why? Why the crisis?
What crisis?
Well, I'm working on that.
Now, folks, this is a shitty business, and it needs no ghosts come from the grave to tell us that. But Lord willing and Jesus tarries, 8 days from now, I'm going to be taking you folks into the second term. Wait till you hear the speech tonight, the 303 speech. Great.
The fact that fear is what's driving a lot of people.
That it is resolved. The CIA confirms that our troops along the Canadian border and overseas are standing down. And I must take this opportunity to call upon our president to state...
What does it mean the situation has been resolved?
He just ended the war.
He ended the war?
Why did he have to go and do that?
I think the CIA just cut a better deal.
He ended the war?
As the innocence of a child. Nothing.
He can't end the war. He's not producing this. President in the polls.
As of today, 89% favorable.
89% favorable is based not on the events, no, which of course events. We cannot control, but on the spin given to those events.
Yes. See, what's the lesson here, Connie? Events. Never give up. Never give up.
Oh, you're right. You were right.
So it must go on.
Proud position. I am prouder of this than anything I ever did in my life.
To a certain extent.
I want to thank you, Connie. Gave me a good opportunity. Thank you.
And as we said, the president, a surefire winner, and the campaign, many said, that put him there.
Someday when they tell this story...
Oh, you can't tell this story.
Why not?
Somebody had to be killed.
No. Of course, no. Not now, but I mean when they do tell the story, Connie.
Nobody can tell this story, sadly, ever.
Someone's got to go to prison, man.